Is a mantra to invoke all our spiritual teachers. So as we sing this together, we consciously invoke our teachers, bring them into these gatherings. Even if the teachers gave you a hard lesson, sometimes we get our hearts broken. We learn more about ourselves through the pain. So we give thanks for all our teachers. Today this is a gathering of gratitude, compassion and forgiveness. We sing together with Deva. Thank you. keep singing.
Namaste.
Namaste, friends. Welcome. We're not going anywhere. Mm-hmm. We here, and we won't be leaving you. We're just gonna be here so we can continue to explore our own inner world together.
Like forever.
We're going to be here forever. Forever and a day. Well, we'll be here as long as we can.
As we're here, basically.
Yeah. But we have no plans to take a break. We feel it is important right now for all of us to come together in this way, and we're not going to let you down. You know, we spent so many years traveling, and towards the end of this lockdown, towards the end of the world as we knew it, we started to question our mode of life, you know, because we were on so many planes, and it started to become obvious that we needed to find another way to be able to share with you. We didn't expect this, but the way technology is going, it won't be so much longer before we'll be sitting in your living room with you, and in some kind of strange and unforeseeable at this moment way. But for sure it's coming. Technology is going to be improving day by day by day.
We don't need technology. We're already doing.
Yeah, but it can be closer, and it can be even more deep, and it can be even more rich. So, yeah, but as it is as it is, and as it is beautiful.
But I mean, we really have a real experience of it now, that there, that space is an illusion, because we are obviously not in the same space, and still we are feeling connected. And I was talking to Maureen, our friend, today, and she said she often doesn't do it live, she does it afterwards. And she does the meditation, the daily meditation, not when we're doing it live, but she watches it afterwards. And she said it feels like, you know, as if you're right there doing it at that same time. And so there's also obviously no time, you know, it doesn't matter if we are doing it at the same time or not, because that's all such human 3D concepts that we're actually experiencing now, that they are not not the ultimate truth, you know. So we don't need holographic images to feel closer, or you know, we are just but it helps to have an anchor, and that's why we feel it's good for us, and what we hear from your message is also good for you, to be there at the same time every day, because it does create a beautiful ritual, and it's a big part of our day, you know, because for us it's 2 p.m. in the day, so it's right in the middle. And there's like these two parts of the day, the before and after the meditation. And it's beautiful, found a beautiful flow.
Okay, I think we can play this one. This is some song that actually Maureen asked for, some Osho songs. This is a song that came from my time in Osho's ashram, and actually, now I think about it, I think it was the first song that ever came to me in a way of wanting to share gratitude with my teacher, and I think I can play it. I haven't played it for many years, but it's like falling leaves blowing away, words disappear, and all I can say is I love you. Like falling leaves blowing away, words disappear, and all I can say. I was born to love you. I was born to love you. Blessed one, you set falling leaves. follow your eyes, and I follow my heart, and I always arrive back at the start, and I see you. Like falling leaves blowing away, words disappear, and all I can say is I love you. I was born to love you. I was born to love you. Blessed one, you set me free. Blessed one, you set me free. Like a fallen it's nice to sing that one, huh? I like that one. I just wanted to say thank you to him, you know. I'm sure many of you have had that experience. I was in such a mess in my life, and then I just read a book with some words of his, and I didn't care that he was controversial. I didn't care about anything. I just said to myself, if there is a community that lives in this way, then I'm going to have to go and find it. And it turned out to be true. So I spent the rest of my life sense of gratitude to life and existence, that it had created such a experience for me that I could meditate and learn what meditation was and learn what real music is, spiritual music, and I learned everything in Osho's ashram, and so I'm forever grateful. I know he was a controversial guy, but so was Jesus. and I think every person who stands for the truth is going to be seen by society at large as suspicious and something to be avoided. That's just the way of nature. That's the way life is. So nothing wrong in it, just the way it is. And since that day, my life has been a miracle. And to be sitting here today with you and with my beloved Deva in this jungle is is unbelievable. It's hard to explain just how miraculous it all feels to me. We just had a beautiful walk this morning to the beach, and we've been sharing our lunch together and eating together and talking and sharing and laughing and crying also. We had many tears today.
I didn't.
No? Not even when you heard from Amy?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so we continue with our meditation, and today we have a very intense dedication today, because we had a very beautiful message from a lady now a part of our Sangha called Amy. And Amy is from Nova Scotia, and she was one of her friends was shot by the murderer who murdered 22 people up there. And her name was Lisa, and Lisa lost her life up there. And Amy wrote to us and asked us if we would dedicate this day to Amy and her sister.
Lisa and her sister.
Sorry.
You said Amy.
Oh no, sorry, Lisa. It was Lisa who lost her life.
Yeah, you said that. Yeah.
And her sister.
Jenny.
And Jenny, this is, if you're here with us today, we're sending you, and you will receive much love today and support. We have no idea of the pain you're going through and the loss you feel, but we want you to know that we're here for you, and this meditation that we will be moving into now is dedicated to you, and to be able to send Lisa on her way. She is free of pain, and she is shining a light on us all. So today, this is very poignant day,
and really for all the people who have been affected by that terrible, terrible tragedy.
Yeah.
Which in a way is all of us, because we all felt with them and with the families, with the people who lost their lives. And the Gayatri is prayer to bring some light into that dark.
So we chant the Gayatri, and we chant it with love, and we chant it with joy. We look for that place inside ourselves which gives us the strength to move through the tragedies and to grow and learn even more compassion, even more forgiveness, even more gratitude. Yeah. So
we find our home in the Om, because the Om is the vibration that is constantly going on and that is unaltered, unmoved. It is always happening.
Yeah.
We give voice to that vibration with all our love.
So make yourself comfortable. Your spine erect. your shoulders relaxed, relaxed awareness. And close your eyes. Come home to your inner sanctuary. The silence and the peace of the inner sanctuary. And chant the mantra Om with Deva, breathing in time with her and allowing the sound to go to the very end of your breath as you chant the mantra Om. And when we come to chanting the Gayatri mantra, keep Lisa in your heart.
Jenny.
Yes, Jenny. And Amy too.
Let's take a deep breath. And breathe out. And a deep breath. Tatsavitur varinya. Bhargo devasya dhimahi. Dhiyo yo. Om Mahasvaha
Join David with the mantra om. Sing together. is so much magnificence near the ocean. Waves are coming in, waves are coming in. There is so much magnificence near the ocean. Waves are coming in, waves are coming in. Are coming in.
And just staying with our eyes closed and that feeling of connectedness and silence. I think this is a good moment to give yourself a really good, long, beautiful hug. Just wrap your arms around you and just, oh, so good to be with you, so good to be with myself.
I remember a beautiful poem by Hafiz, who says, "Do you know how beautiful you are?"
Mm.
"I think not, my dear. Your beauty, true beauty." And share your beauty with your world. We need it now more than ever. We need to be connected more than ever.
And respect to yourself that you sit down every day to meditate and to go inside and to give yourself your space. This is so precious and so nourishing. And
yourself.
Oh, I'm giving myself a hug.
Giving yourself a hug. I see you tomorrow, beloveds. Have a beautiful ongoing part of your day, whether it's in the morning in Australia or the evening in England, wherever. Send love. Namaste.
Namaste.